Pelvic inflammatory disease is an infection of the female reproductive organs, including the uterus, fallopian tubes, and ovaries. It is a serious condition that can lead to complications such as infertility, chronic pelvic pain, and ectopic pregnancy if left untreated. PID is usually caused by bacterial infections, often transmitted sexually. The most common pathogens include Neisseria gonorrhoeae and Chlamydia trachomatis. Normal vaginal flora overgrowth, such as Gardnerella vaginalis and Mycoplasma genitalium. Post-surgical or procedural infection after childbirth, abortion, or IUD insertion. Untreated lower genital tract infections, such as cervicitis or vaginitis. PID symptoms can range from mild to severe and may include lower abdominal and pelvic pain. Abnormal vaginal discharge with an unusual odor. Painful urination. Pain during sexual intercourse. Irregular menstrual bleeding or spotting. Fever and chills. Nausea and vomiting. Some women may have silent PID with minimal or no symptoms, which increases the risk of complications due to delayed diagnosis. Diagnosis is primarily clinical, based on symptoms, risk factors, and physical examination. On physical examination, pelvic tenderness, cervical motion tenderness, and adnexal tenderness on bimanual examination may be elicited. Vaginal and cervical swabs for nucleic acid amplification test to detect chlamydia and gonorrhea. Complete blood count may reveal elevated WBC count. ESR and CRP may be elevated. Urinalysis to rule out urinary tract infections. Pelvic ultrasound to detect tubo-ovarian abscess or hydrosalpinx. MRI or CT scan in severe cases to help assess complications. Laparoscopy may help in direct visualization of inflamed fallopian tubes, adhesions, or pus. The treatment of PID involves the use of antibiotic therapy. Empirical broad-spectrum antibiotics covering gonorrhea, chlamydia, and anaerobes should be started immediately. For outpatient treatment, ceftriaxone 500 mg intramuscular single dose, plus doxycycline 100 mg twice daily for 14 days, plus metronidazole 500 mg twice daily for 14 days. For inpatient treatment in severe cases, intravenous ceftriaxone plus doxycycline plus metronidazole, followed by oral therapy after improvement. Alternatively, intravenous clindamycin plus gentamicin. For tubo-ovarian abscess, drainage via laparoscopic or ultrasound-guided aspiration. For severe complications, salpingectomy may be required. Partner treatment and pre-sexual partners should be screened and treated to prevent reinfection. Patients should avoid sexual activity until treatment is completed. Condom use and STI screening help prevent PID. If untreated, PID can lead to infertility. Scarring of fallopian tubes may block fertilization. Ectopic pregnancy due to tubal damage. Adhesions and scarring cause persistent pain. Tubo-ovarian abscess. Peritonitis and sepsis. And that's all for this video. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative health content. Stay tuned for our next video.